Hi guys, and welcome to yet another episode of Xavier's Buzz, where we talk about various issues and events held at St. Xavier's College, Mapusa. Xavier's is not only known for its academics, but also has a lot of budding talents. And to give these budding talents a direction, Xavier's has organized its cultural inaugural. So, let's switch to Disha to take a glance of this event.
St. Xavier's College has always been known for carrying out the cultural activities along with academics. Embarking this journey, St. Xavier celebrated its cultural inaugural in the month of July. The program commenced with lighting of the lamp by the dignitaries. Chief guest, Ms. Asunta Montero, Principal of the college, Dr. Jerome De Silva, Vice Principal of the college, Ms. Blanche Mascarenhas.
It has almost become a tradition now in our college to have a formal inaugural to our cultural activities. By having such a formal function or an inaugural, it only speaks about the importance that is given to the co-curricular activities, because they are so very important to the overall development of our students.
The sports magazine Altius was released by the chief guest, Asunta Montero. The program was filled with a lot of entertaining performances by various clubs of the college. Appreciated the hard work of the students and teachers.
This institution, you are doing an amazing job. I know it is an uphill task, but remember, you are molding and shaping the lives of students. You are actually building our future.
Cultural coordinator Arina spoke to us about the importance of the cultural activities in the college life.
Cultural activities, students get exposed, they get experience in taking part in events and organizing events. They also learn to make friends.
This is Disha Jain signing off with camera person Christine Arona.
In addition to the cultural inaugural, Xavier's also had his NSS unit's inaugural. So, let's take a glimpse of the event. Over to you, Rohan.
The NSS unit has been active in St. Xavier's College for a long time. The inaugural started with a Bharatanatyam performance. The program began with the lighting of the lamp by chief guest Sister Monica Coelho, Principal Dr. Father Geronimo De Silva, the NSS coordinator Sir Carmelito De Souza, General Secretary Kushal Kerkar, and Cultural Secretary Shreyas Bandu. In his welcome address, Father Geronimo highlighted the importance of NSS in college.
My dear students, keep the NSS motto always close to your heart. Yes, when you do something good to others, when you think good of others, and when you do something good to others, it always comes back to you.
To make the afternoon more lively, the NSS students showcased their talents with many performances. Speaking on the occasion, Chief Guest Sister Monica Coelho, who is an auditor by profession, shared her thoughts about the role of NSS in college life.
For you to go ahead as you march in this year 2017-2018, at the very onset, I wish you all the very best, God's abundant blessings, and whatever you need to go on to carry on in this full of activities that are just listed to us.
The vote of thanks was proposed by the Cultural Secretary.
The Jeremy Modi Silva for his kind support and guidance today and always. A big thank you to our NSS program officer, Sir Kamarito D'Souza, and all the program officers and the PROs, without whom this day wouldn't be possible.
Talking about the program, the students had a lot to share.
Last year we saw that very few NSS volunteers took part in NSS. But this year I'm looking forward for more participation from all the NSS volunteers.
Like last year we had taken up this project, which was titled as Ek Rakhi Sainika Sati. So that was organized by the ex-environment and forest minister, that was Sir Rajendra Alekar. And he came up with this project, so we thought of lending some hand towards this project. So this project is all about rakhis that have been sent to the soldiers out on the borders who are not able to celebrate this festival called Raksha Bandhan.
And I really appreciate the hard work of all the NSS volunteers who put forth while making the program, like the invocation dance and all the cultural dance activities what we had, the musical drama. We really appreciated everyone's efforts towards it, all the PROs, the cultural coordinators, everyone. So the program was overall a very nice program.
This is Rohan Pinto signing off with camera person Ratisha Faldesai.
Moving on, GST has become one of the trending topics nowadays. So let's take a look on how much people have understood the concept of GST. Here we have some exclusive scoop at Xavier's Express.
Hi guys, and welcome to Xavier's Express. As you all know, the GST is the trending topic nowadays since it has affected a lot of people in various good and bad ways. Basically, GST is a goods and service tax. It's a common tax for all the goods and services in India. So let's take a look at what people has to say about GST.
So according to you, what is GST?
GST is goods and services tax, and these taxes are applicable for each and every product.
So, has your buying pattern changed due to GST?
Yeah, because the food products or the footwear or the clothing, the rates on them has increased because of this tax.
Do you know what GST is?
I don't know what is exactly GST, but I know the full form. Goods and service tax.
तुम्ही तुमच्या प्रोडक्टसाठी GST apply केला?
अजूनपर्यंत ना. सिस्टम सारखी वर्कआउट जाऊ ना त्यांची GST ची. Software problems asa from dealer side. 75% businessman has not understood what is GST, how to apply it, how to transfer it to the customer, how you will get benefit from the GST.
So have you implemented, have you applied GST to your products?
Yeah, we have applied GST to our products.
According to you, how the market has affected due to GST?
Market, actually nowadays, due to GST, rates have come up, they have increased in rates. When I like to go in mobile, it has come down to 12, from 12.5 to 12. But in some commodities, the rates have been increased. So it becomes very difficult for common people to buy. Because the rates have increased, so it affects them very badly because they can't buy. If they want to buy a television set or a fridge or something, they can't buy because the rates have increased on those products. So if certain things can be reduced, even there is an increase in clothes items, so that people cannot easily buy branded stuff. So if there is something where they could take charges and they could think about people, common people buying good things, because they earn, they do hard work and then they earn something and then they buy some satisfying goods. So I think government should think about it. From there it has affected.
So do you think that GST is beneficial for our country?
I don't think so. Because not just the rich people but the common people suffer more. So I think GST should be implemented above poverty, above poverty line people, only to those particular people, not everybody like that. I feel so, according to a common person.
Hope you all guys enjoyed today's episode. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe our channel. Bye.
Thank you for watching Xavier's Buzz. This is Ratisha Faldesai. That's all for this week. We'll be back with some interesting stories, perspectives and reports from St. Xavier's College, Mapusa. Please do like,
share
and subscribe our channel. Until then, bye.